Hello everyone, once again welcome to PM Networking. Hope you all are doing great. Guys, today we will discuss 7 types of LSA in OSPF. This is a user demand video. One of my subscribers has requested me to make one video on types of LSA. So there are 11 type of LSA in OSPF, but LSA 8, LSA 9, LSA 11 and LSA 6 are not in used. Right, so we will discuss LSA 1, LSA 2, LSA 3, LSA 4, LSA 5 and LSA 7. LSA 6, LSA 8, 9, 10, 11 are not in use. Fine. So first of all we will discuss router LSA. So guys, router LSA, every router, always keep in mind that every router in OSPF domain will generate LSA 1, and LSA 1 can't cross area. This is problem with LSA 1. LSA 1 can't cross area, and we called OSPF is a link state routing protocol, because database of every router in OSPF domain will be identical, means same database of all router in OSPF domain will same. That's why we called OSPF is a link state routing protocol, because with the help of database router can design entire topology, right? But it's not true. OSPF is a link state routing protocol within area, between area. OSPF is a distance vector routing protocol. Suppose we have three router, R1, R2 and R3. Okay, suppose here is one LAN network 10.1.1.0/24. Here is one LAN network 10.1.2.0/24. Here is one LAN network 10.1.3.0/24. Fine. So if you will see the database of router 1, router 2 and router 3, database of all router will be same if these three router belongs to same area. Suppose these three router belongs to area 0, then only database of all router will be same. Suppose here is one router R0, right, in area 1, not like this. Here we need one edge router to connect to different area. Suppose this is in area 1, right? So database of router 0 and router 1 will be different. So this router 0 can't design entire topology of OSPF. So between area, OSPF is a distance vector routing protocol, but within area, OSPF is a link state routing protocol. Router 1 can design this topology with the help of router LSA. We will discuss how. We will discuss both theory as well as practical to all LSA. Fine. So first of all we will discuss router LSA. Router LSA, every router will be generated LSA, every router will generate LSA 1, that is router LSA, but router LSA can't cross area. Fine. So here guys, in this topology, as you can see over here, router 1, router 2 and router 3 belongs to area 0. So database of these three router will be identical, right? So router 1 can design this complete topology with the help of LSA 1 in database, right? So as you know, OSPF router maintain database. In their database they will store LSA, and first type of LSA is router LSA. So every router 1, 2, 3 will generate LSA, and that LSA will be flooded in this area, in area 0. If I will talk about router 4, this router will also generate LSA 1, but this LSA will be flooded in this area only, in area 1 only. So router 3 will have LSA of area 0 also and LSA of area 1 also. So guys, tell me, how many LSA 1 router will have? Router will have 3 number of LSA 1, LSA 1 of router 1, LSA 1 of router 2, LSA 1 of router 3. How many LSA 1 router 4 will have? 2 number of LSA, router 3 and router 4. How many number of LSA 1 router 3 will have? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 number of LSA 1. Fine. because router 3 is connected to area 0 also and area 1 also. Fine. So first of all, let me configure this domain, only this domain. Right, here I will show you something about LSA 1, then we will move to LSA 2. We will discuss all 7 types of LSA one by one. Okay, first of all, let me configure this router. Go to configure terminal interface, F0/0, say no set, and IP address is 10.1.1.1, submit mask 255.255.255.0, exit interface serial 2/0, say no set here, sorry, no set, and IP address is suppose 12.0.0.1 255.0.0.0. Let me configure OSPF, router OSPF 100 or 1. Process ID is locally significant, we can configure same as well and different as well. 1, and router ID is 1.1.1.1. router ID is used to represent the database, right? Every OSPF router use router ID, uses router ID to represent their database. This is identification of database, or you can say identification of router in OSPF domain. Okay, now if you will run command, so IP OSPF database, you can see the LSA. So IP interface brief exclude and assign is there. Okay, so line protocol of this interface is down, right? So IPOSPF database, there is no any LSA in the database of router 1. So once I will advertise network, or once I will advertise interface in OSPF, right, router will add that link in LSA 1. Why router generate LSA 1 to share the information of link. So every router will generate LSA 1. In their LSA 1, there will be information of link, so it will add, router 1 will add this link and this link in LSA 1, right? So every router 2 will also generate LSA 1, it will add this link, router 3 will add this link. So every router will add their directly connected link in their LSA 1, right? But now on R1, you can see there is no any LSA 1, because I haven't advertised any interface in OSPF. Okay, so once I will advertise this interface in OSPF, right, it will generate LSA 1. How router 1 will represent their LSA 1? With the help of router ID will be 1.1.1. in LSA 1, there will be information of link, like I have one link in OSPF and link ID is F0/0. On this link we are running network 10.0.0.0 or 10.1.1.0. subnet mask on this link is 255.255.255.0, and cost of this link is 1. In the same way, it will add this link also in their LSA 1. Fine. So let me show you guys practically, it will make you more clear. So go to router number 1 and let me advertise network. Router OSPF process ID 1 and network, let me advertise all active interface in OSPF 0.0.0. wildcard mask is 255.255.255 and area is 0. So IPOSPF database, here you can see now the database of router 1. In the database of router 1, there is one LSA. How this router is representing this LSA? With the help of router ID, right? 1.1.1. If you will open this LSA in detail, first of all tell me how you will came to know that this is LSA 1. Here you can see this is router LSA, and router LSA is LSA 1. LSA 1 of which area? Area 0, right? And how many link are there in this LSA? Only one link. Why only one link? There are two link, guys. This is serial 2/0 is also connected to router 1, but line protocol of this link is done. So first of all, let me configure router 2, then I will show you LSA 1 of router 1. So go to config tree first of all, after that interface serial 2/0, say no set, and IP address is 12.0.0.2.255.0.0.0. exit interface F0/0, say no set, and IP address is 10.1.2.1.255.255.255.0. exit interface serial 2/1, no set, IP address 23.1.1.2 or 23.0.0.2 255.0.0.0. exit. Fine, now come to router number 1. IP configuration of R2 is done. Now so IPO SPF database, see how many link are there in this LSA 1. There are 2 link. If you will open this LSA in detail, command will be so IPO SPF database router, and you want to open the detailed information of router LSA. Router LSA of which router? 1.1.1. router LSA of 1.1.1.1. see, first of all, this is header of LSA 1. In every LSA there will be LSA header. So this is header of LSA 1, and these are information of link. These are information of link. Okay, so here as you can see, there are how many link? There are 2 link. But on serial link, router will consider their neighbor as a link as well, right? So there is no neighborship, that's why there is only 2 link. After that, once neighborship between router 1 and router 2 will form, you will see there will be 3 link in LSA 1 of router 1. Okay, leave it for now. See first of all, what is information inside LSA 1? Information is link connected to a stub network. A stub network means directly connected network. A network is directly connected with me. After that, that network is 12.0.0.0. subnet mask of that network is this one, and cost of that link is 64. And there is one more stub network, that is 10.1.1.0. this is subnet mask, and metric is 1. Fine, this is LSA 1. Guys, here you need to understand something, that in every LSA, in all LSA, there will be 2 information. First one is link state ID, and second one is advertising router ID, right? Advertising router ID in every LSA will be same. Router ID of router who is advertising that LSA. Router ID of, just like who is advertising this LSA? Router 1. So in advertising router ID, you can see this is router ID of router 1. And in link state ID, in LSA 1, link state ID will be also the router ID of advertising router ID, but link state ID will be different in other LSA. Maybe in LSA 2, in network LSA, link state ID will be the IP address of DR, right? So we will discuss what will be the link state ID in different LSA, but keep in mind, in router LSA, in LSA 1, link state ID and advertising router ID will be same, right? Router ID of router who is advertising that LSA. And always keep in mind one thing, that all the odd number LSA, like LSA 1, LSA 2, LSA 3 and LSA 5, these are odd number LSA. So these LSA are used to share the information of prefixes. These LSA are used to share the information of prefixes, or you can say used to share the information of networks. But if I will talk about even number LSA, like LSA 2, even number LSA, sorry, odd number LSA. Odd number LSA is used to share the information of prefixes LSA 1, LSA 3 and LSA 5. And even number LSA, like LSA 2, LSA 4, LSA 6, LSA 8. These LSA are used to share the information of router. Sometime how many router are connected in a broadcast network or how many router are connected in a multi-segment network. Sometime the information of ESBR router. So we will understand about that information as well. But keep in mind that all the odd number LSA is used to share the network information, and all the even number LSA is used to share the information of something else. Okay. And in LSA 1 router store the information of directly connected link. Fine. Now this is LSA 1 of router 1. This is header and these are information of link. Now let me configure OSPF on router 2. So command will be router OSPF process ID 1 and router ID is 2.2.2.2. After that network. Network is, let me advertise all active network in area 0. Area 0. Once neighborship between router 1 and router 2 will form. See now database of router LSA of router 1. There is 3 link now. So here you can see link is connected to another router, point to point. Neighbor router ID is 2.2.2. So on serial link, router will consider their neighbor as a link, right? On serial link only, not on Ethernet link. So it's considering their neighbor as a link. So that's why it will show you there are 3 number of link. Here you can see in header number of link is 3, but in actual there are only 2 link, right? One is F0/0 and one is serial 2/0. Fine. See, now database is identical or not. So IPOSPF database, this is database of router 1, and let me show you database of router 2. So IPOSPF database, this is database of router 2. See, database is same of router 1 also and router 2 also, right? Is there any difference between database of router 1 and router 2? No. That's why we called OSPF is a link state routing protocol within area. Okay, now let me configure R3. So here configure terminal interface serial 2/0, say no set, and here IP address will be what? 23.1.1.2.255.255.0.0.3.255.0.0.0. exit interface serial 2/1 no set, and IP address is suppose 34.0.0.4.255.0.0. exit. Right, here if I will configure OSPF router OSPF 1, router ID 3.3.3.3, right? And here I can't run network 0.0.0 because I will advertise this interface in area 0 and this interface in area 1. So here we will configure OSPF on interface basis. Then we will discuss type 3 LSA. Okay, first of all let me show you here. Go to interface serial 2/0 and IP OSPF process ID 1 and area is 0. Area is 0. So if you will check database of router 3, so you can see database of router 3, router 1 and router 2 will be same. Now in the database of router 2, there will be 3 number of LSA 1. You can see here. In the same way, if you will check database of router 1, there will be 3 number of LSA 1. Fine. There will be 3 number of LSA 1. So this is database of router 1. And see guys, this is LSA 1 of router 1. How many link are there in this LSA, in LSA 1 of router 1? 3. Because there are 2 physical link and 1 neighbor. So router is considering their neighbor as a link, right? Because here I am using serial link. In the database of router 2, or you can say LSA 1 of router 2, there are how many link? 5. There are 5 link. Because you can see over here on router 2, there are 3 physical link and 2 neighbor. So router 2 is also considering their neighbor as a link. So that's why there are 5 link. Fine. See the database of router 3. There are 2 link. One is physical link, this link, and one is their neighbor. Fine. So this is database of these 3 router. And database of all these router is same, identical. So that's why we called OSPF is an link state routing protocol within area. Okay. Now, understand LSA 2. First of all, hope it's clear to you what is the use of LSA 1. LSA 1 is used to share the information of link, right? Every router will generate LSA 1, but LSA 1 will be flooded within area only. LSA 1 can't cross area. Okay, this is it's and everything about LSA 1. We don't need to focus anything else. And one more thing, in advertising router ID, in advertising router ID field, there will be information of router who is advertising that LSA, and in link state ID, there will be information of router who is advertising that LSA, right? Same information in both field, link state ID as well as advertising router ID. Now, what is the use of LSA 2? Here we need to design one more topology. So see, this is router 5, router 6, router 7, and router 8. We have 8 router connected through one switch. So this is my broadcast network, right? What is the use of LSA 1? LSA 1 is used to share the information of directly connected link, right? And every router will generate LSA 1, and LSA 1 can be flooded within area. LSA 1 cannot cross area. This is all about LSA 1. Let me turn on this device and let me configure router 8 first. So this is broadcast network. So here DR and BDR election will happen, occur, right? So one router will become DR. Which router will become DR? Because first of all, for DR and BDR election, router will check priority. So by default, priority on all router will be same. So it will check router ID. So router who have highest router ID, they will win the DR and BDR election completion, right? So router whose router ID is highest, that router will become DR. Let me configure R8. And I will not participate these router in DR BDR election. So what I can do, I can set priority 0 on these 3 router. So these 3 router will not participate in DR and BDR election. So router 8 will become DR. First of all, let me configure very quickly. Interface F0/0, say no set, and IP address is suppose 10.0.0.1.255.0.0.0. Exit router OSPF 1, and router ID is 8.8.8.8, and network is 0.0.0 wildcard mask. We can run 0.0.0 as well. Area 0. Go to lot order number 7. Config t interface f 0/0. No set. IP address is 10.0.0.2.255.0.0.0. Exit router OSPF 1. Router ID is 7.7.7.7. Right, and network is 0.0.0.0.0 area 0. Area 0 and interface F0/0. IPOSPF priority is 0. So it will not participate in DR and BDR election. Let me configure router 6. Config t interface F0/0. Say no set, and IP address is 10.0.0.3.255.0.0. Exit router OSPF 1. Router ID is 6.6.6.6 and network is 0.0.0.0.0 area 0. Fine. Now let me configure router number 5. So first of all, in this broadcast network, every router will generate LSA1 to share the information of prefix, right? No set. And DR router will generate LSA2 to share the information of directly connected 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 5, 2, share the information of directly connected router in this segment. Exit router OSPF 1. Router ID 5.5.5.5. Fine. And network 0.0.0.0.0.0 and area 0. Exit interface F0/0. IPOSPF priority 0. Fine. Now if you will check database of router 5. So IPOSPF database. So guys, see, these are LSA1. This is LSA1 of router 5, LSA1 of router 6, LSA1 of router 7, LSA1 of router 8, right? And in every LSA, in LSA1 of every router, there are only one link, right? So here you can see, not considering their neighbor as a link, because here I am using Ethernet link, and this is network LSA. Who is generating 8.8.8? 8.8.8 is DR. So IP OSPF neighbor. So yes, 8.8.8 is DR, right? And 6.6.6 is BDR. Okay, so let me set priority 0 here. So this router will not become BDR. IP OSPF 1 priority. IP OSPF process ID 1 and priority okay. Interface F0/0. IPOSPF priority 0. Okay. So who is DR? 8.8.8. So DR router will generate LSA2. So IPOSPF database. Only DR router will generate LSA2. Here you can see advertising router ID is 8.8.8 and link ID is IP address of DR, right? You can see on router 8. This is my router 8. Where is router 8? Yeah, set. Yes, this one. Let me maximize it. So IP OSPF interface F0/0. Here you can see a state of this interface is DR, priority is 1, and IP address of this interface is 10.0.0.1. So DR IP address is 10.1, right? So in LSA 2, advertising router ID will be the router ID of router who will advertise that LSA, means router ID of DR, and in link state ID there will be information of IP address of DR router. And if you will open this LSA in detailed, there will be information of attached router in this segment. So IP OSPF database, after that network LSA 10.0.0.1. See, there is information of attached router, that how many router are attached in this segment, because guys, see here, in this segment this is my DR. So this is DR other, DR other, DR other, right? So every router will generate LSA 1, router 5 will generate LSA 1 also, it will send to switch will forward it to DR, right? Forward it to DR, and DR will forward it to router 7 and router 6. Then how this router will came to know about other DR other, that how many DR other are present in this network, with the help of LSA 2, with the help of LSA 2. So for that, DR router will generate LSA 2 to share the information of directly connected router in this segment. The DR router is telling to DR other that there are how many router? 4 router, whose router ID is this one, router whose router ID is 8.8.8, router whose router ID is 5.5.5, 6.6.6, 7.7.7. Okay, so every router in an area will generate LSA 1, DR router will generate LSA 2 to share the information of directly connected router in broadcast network. Then what is the use of LSA 3 now, right? Now we will discuss use of LSA 3. Let me erase this topology. Okay, here guys, in this network you can see LSA 1 of router 1 can't cross area, right? Means LSA 1 of router 1 will not reach to router 4. In the same way, LSA 1 of router 4 will not reach to R1. Then how R1 and R2 will share their prefix information of their link? So how router 1 can communicate with router 4? Not possible, right? Not possible. Because router 1 will generate LSA 1 to share the information of this link and this link to their neighbor. Their neighbor will forward it to their neighbor. But router 3 will not forward it that LSA 1 from area 0 to area 1, right? In the same way, when router 4 will generate their LSA 1, that LSA 1 will be shared by router 3. But router 3 will not forward that LSA 1 in area 0 from area 1. LSA 1 can't cross area. This is rule. So how R1 and R4 can communicate, or how R2 and R4 can communicate, right? So that's why ABR router will generate LSA 3 to share information of inter area OSPF domain, right? With the help of LSA 3, ABR router will share the information of this area network into this area, and this area network into this area, right? Is area ki sari network is area mein dega, aur is area ki sari network is area mein dega. ABR router. So ABR router will generate LSA 3 to share the network information of inter area. Fine. So let me configure router 3 and let me show you LSA 3 as well. Okay. So run router. OSPF section here. Okay, So let me advertise this interface serial2/0 in area 0, IPOSPF process ID 1 and area 0. Let me advertise this interface serial2/1 in area 1, IP OSPF process ID 1 and area 1. Right now this router will become ABR router. This router will become ABR router. Let me configure router 4 first, then I will show you. Config T interface serial2/0 say no set and IP address. IP address is 34.0.0.4 and 255.0.0.0. Fine. After that, interface F0/0 say no set and IP address is 10.1.14.0 suppose 4.1 255.255.255.0 exit. So IP OSPF neighbor. So IP OSPF neighbor, let me ping. Okay, let me ping first 34.0.0.3. Oh, I am not able to ping. Let me check configuration. So IP interface brief exclude unassigned. So IP configuration is fine. Let me configure, check IP configuration on router 3. So IP interface brief exclude unassigned. So you can see on serial2/1 IP address is this one 34.4 and on router 4 IP address is 34.4. okay, so here we need to change. Here I will configure 34.3 interface serial2/1 IP address is 34.0.0.3 255.0.0.0. okay, so IP OSPF neighbor, so 2.2 neighbor is full ping 34.0.0.4. yes, I am able to ping. So IP OSPF neighbor, let me check OSPF configuration on router 4. So run section router OSPF. Okay, so I haven't configured OSPF here, na? Okay, router OSPF process ID 1 and router ID is 4.4.4.4. Okay, the network is 0.0.0.255.255.255.255 and area 1. So IP OSPF neighbor. So you can see neighbor is in full state and there is no DR and BDR because I am using serial link. On serial link, network type is point to point. So in next video we will discuss network type in OSPF. Don't worry about that, leave it for now. Right, when DR BDR election will happen, not when not will happen. Okay, so IP OSPF database. So guys, see, this is database of router 4. Right, in the database of router 4 there is two number of LSA 1, LSA 1 of router 3, LSA 1 of router 4. Fine, because there are only two router in this area. Okay, and there are some LSA 3. This is summary LSA, right? And here you can see who is advertising this LSA, router 3, and router 3 is ABR. That's why router 3 is generating 3.3.3 is generating, right? And in link ID you can see there is information of network. So how many LSA 3 router 3 will generate for area 1? How many LSA 3 router 3 will generate for area 1? How many number of prefixes are present in area 0? 1, 2, 3 and 4. There are 4 network in area 0. So router 3 will generate 4 number of LSA 3 for area 1 to share the information of the network information of area 0. You can see here there are 4 LSA 3. Who is generating? ABR router. And tell me, how many LSA 3 ABR router will generate for area 0? How many prefixes are there in area 1? 1 and 2. So 2 LSA 3 will be generated by ABR router for area 0. So you can see the database of router 1 now. So IPOSPF database. These are LSA 1 and these are LSA 3. Who is generating 3.3.3, 3.3.3, and there is information of prefix. One is 10.1.4.0 and 34.0.0.0, and this router will install this prefix in their routing table as well. So IP route OSPF, you can see 10.1.4.0, and here you can see symbol is OIA. OI means OSPF inter area, right? So if a router will calculate prefix with the help of LSA 3 in their routing table, that prefixes will be present in database in routing table with this symbol, with OIA. If router will calculate prefix in their routing table with LSA 1, then router will install that prefix in their routing table with O symbol. If router will calculate prefix with LSA 3, with the help of LSA 3, it will install in their routing table with this symbol OIA, OSPF inter area, and this router can ping 10.1.4.1. see, this router is able to ping. And so IP root OSPF, see, cost for this network is what? 193. How this router calculate cost for this network? 193. So IP OSPF border router. Now this router have knowledge that border router is 3.3.3, and cost to reach border router is what? Cost to reach border router is 128, and it will check their database. So IP OSPF database, in their database there is LSA 3 where information is 10.1.4.0 network. So it will open this database in detail, right? Which LSA? Summary LSA of 10.1.4.0, and here you can see metric is what? 65, right? That means who is advertising this network? 3.3.3. So from 3.3.3 to this network, cost is what? 65. And from me to 3.3.3, cost is 128. So total cost for 10.1.4.0 will be what? Will be 128 plus 64. Cost to reach ABR is, let me check, 128, and cost from ABR to 10.1.4 is 65. So total cost is 193. So router will install this prefix in their routing table with metric 193. Okay. And a router can design their complete database, complete topology, with the help of LSA1. Let me show you with the help of LSA1 how router 1 can design complete topology. So IPOSPF database. See, with the help of LSA1, router will came to know that there are 3 router, 1.1.1, 2.2.2 and 3.3.3. Then router will open their LSA1 first, their own LSA1, router 1.1.1. This is LSA1 of router 1. Now With the help of this command, router will came to know that I am a router whose router ID is what? 1.1.1.1, right? So router 1. And link connected to another router. This is connected to one another router whose router ID is, neighboring router ID is what? 2.2.2.2. Fine. Router interface IP address is what? 12.1. And cost of this link is what? 64. Fine. Then a link is connected to stub network. Stub network means directly connected network, where we are running which network? 12.0.0.0. So definitely here I am running 12.0.0.0 network, and cost of this link is 64. And a link is connected to a stub network means there is one more directly connected network where I am running this network 10.1.1.0/24, submit mask, and cost of this link is 1. Then router will open LSA 1 in detail of router 2. So if router 1 will open, so IPOSPF database router and 2.2.2.2, then this router will came to know that okay, so see, this is header. This is header. Let me wait, guys. Okay, so this is header, and here you can see link connected to another router. That is router ID is 3.3.3. Means router 2 is connected to one another router whose router ID is 3.3.3.3. This is R2, and this is R3. And cost of that link is 64. Cost of that link is 64, and router interface IP address is 23.2. So here IP address is 23.2, right? And link is connected to a stub network. Link is connected to a stub network. There are some information are missing here. Let me check again. Okay, so these are complete information of 2.2.2. Okay, so see, link is connected to another router point to point 3.3, IP address is this one, and cost of this link is 64. Then link connected to a stub network, that is 23.0.0, definitely talking about this network. Here I am running 23.0.0.0 network, submit mask is this one, and cost of this link is 64. Then link is connected to another router whose router ID is 1.1.1, definitely talking about router 1, right? About this router. Okay, then link is connected to a stub network where I am running this network. Okay, fine, definitely talking about this network. Then link connected to a stub network where I am running this network, right? So link connected to a stub network where 10.1.2.0, and submit mask is 24, cost of this link is 1. Fine, then it will open. So then router 1 will open detailed LSA 1 of router 3. This is LSA 1 of router 3 in detail. So see, link connected to another router, and router ID of that router is 2.2.2, definitely talking about router 2. Here I am running this network, and cost of this link is this one. And link connected to a stub network 23.0.0.0, right, where I am running network 23, definitely talking about this network, right? And cost of this link is this one. After that, here is no any LAN. So see, this is complete topology. This topology and this topology is same. So router can design a complete topology with the help of LSA1, right? So till now we have discussed LSA1, LSA2 and LSA3. Now we will discuss LSA4. For that I will open my topology, different topology. Let me close this topology. Okay, and let me open one topology, GNS task OSPF area, this topology. Just wait, it will take some time. LSA 3 will be generated by ABR router to share the information, prefix information of inter area. Okay, see this topology first. Now we will discuss LSA 4 and LSA 5 and LSA 7. LSA 4, LSA 5 and LSA 7. So guys, first of all, see here. Don't think about this part. Don't think about this part. Okay? I will not consider this part here and this part here. Fine? Okay. First of all, let me discuss one thing, then I will come in this topology. How ABR router will tell to their neighbor that I am ABR? Suppose this is my topology. R1, R2, R3, R4. This is area 0. And this is area 1. How R1 will tell to 1, 2, 3, 4? How R3 will tell to R2 that I am ABR? So what R3 will do? What ABR router will do? ABR router will on one bit in LSA 1. ABR router will on one bit in LSA 1. Which bit? B bit. In LSA 1, in flag field, there are three fields: B bit, E bit, and V bit. B bit will on ABR router. Whenever a router will receive LSA 1 with B bit on, then router will came to know that. So router who is advertising this LSA 1 is ABR, right? When a router will receive LSA 1 with E bit on, then router will came to know that, okay, I am receiving on LSA 1 with E bit on. That means the router who is advertising this LSA 1 is ASBR. ASBR. Listen again. Whenever a router will receive LSA 1 with B bit on, then router will came to know that router who is advertising this LSA 1 is ABR. And when a router will receive LSA 1 with E bit on, that router will came to know that. So router will came to know that the router who is advertising this LSA 1 is ASBR. Okay. So ABR will on E bit and ASBR will on E bit. So here in this topology, here you can see I am running EIGRP, here I am running OSPF area 0, and here I am running OSPF area 3, here I am running EIGRP 100. So these two router will become ABR, right? This router will become ASBR and this router will become ASBR. Am I right? Right? So when ASBR router will generate LSA 1, first of all, when ABR router will generate LSA 1, it will on B bit. Then router 1 will came to know that, okay, router 4 is ABR. Let me show you. So IPOSPF border router. See, 4.4.4 is ABR and 5.5.5 is ABR, right? If you will capture this link, let me capture this link and let me don serial 0/0 of router 4. I will don this interface and I will run no shutdown command again. So that router 4 will generate LSA 1 again. Just wait, it will take some time. Okay, till then let me discuss few few more things. Okay, so see, when this order will generate LSA1, it will on B bit. Fine. Is there any problem? No. R1 will came to know that 4.4.4 is ABR, 5.5.5 is ABR. But when ASBR will generate LSA1, it will on E bit. Right? In their LSA1 of router 10, it will on E bit. So router 9 will came to know that router 10 is ASBR. Router 4 will came to know that router 10 is ASBR. Router 5 will came to know that router 10 is ASBR. But LSA1 cannot cross area, then how router 1 will came to know that router 10 is ASBR? Right? Question is, how router 1 will came to know that router 10 is ASBR? When router 2 is also ASBR router, right? So when router 2 will generate LSA1, it will on E bit in their LSA1. So router 1 will came to know that router 2 is ASBR. Router 4 will came to know that router 2 is ASBR. Router 5 will came to know that router 2 is ASBR. But how router 9 will came to know that router 2 is ASBR? So this is problem, right? So guys, for that ABR router will generate LSA4. ABR router will generate LSA4 to share the information of ASBR, right? ABR, this router and this router will generate LSA4 to share the information of ASBR. So how router 1 will came to know that router 10 is ASBR? With the help of LSA4. And who will generate that LSA4? ABR router. Okay, so I think this is not ABR router. Now I will perform redistribution on this router, so this router will become ASBR. Then I will show you. First of all, let me show you B bit. So see, this is router 4, configuration of router 4, and config T interface serial 2/0 and say shut and say no shut again. Okay, who is sending this update message? 14.4 update message. In this update message, let me open LSA1 link state update. This is LSA1. In LSA1, you can see in flag this bit is off. Okay, wait. This is update of router 4. See, B bit is on because it is ABR. And let me perform redistribution here. So router 1, router 4 and router 5 will send E bit on LSA1. So router 1 will came to know that router 4 and router 5 is ABR. So IPOSPF border router, you can see there is information of ABR. Okay, now let me perform redistribution here on router 10. So IP protocol, I am running both protocol, EIGRP and OSPF. EIGRP 200 and OSPF 1, right? So let me perform redistribution here. Router OSPF 1 redistribute EIGRP 200. After that, we need to use subnet key. Fine. Now this router will become ASBR. So IP protocol see, it is an autonomous system border router, and if I will capture this link, so it will send their LSA1 with EBIT on, with EBIT on. In my live training, I have explained this topology in very details, right? So definitely, once I will record the video of this topology, I will upload that video also on my YouTube channel. That will make you more clear. So you can verify it. ASBR router will generate LSA1 with EBIT on, right? Then router 9 will came to know that. Router 10 is ASBR. Router 4, router 5 will came to know that. Router 10 is ASBR. And in area 0, router 4 and router 5 will generate what? LSA4. Let me show you. So IP OSPF database. Summary, ASBR, right? Who is generating? Router 4 and router 5. And there is information of ASBR. This is router ID of router 10, 10.10.10, right? This is router ID of router 10. Fine. So who will generate LSA4? ABR router, to share the information of ASBR, right? Different area mein router LSA4 generate karke ASBR ki information deta hai. Fine. In the same way, when I will perform redistribution on R2, router 4 and router 5 will generate LSA4 to share the information of 2.2.2 to router 9, right? Router 10. Router LSA4 can cross area. There is no problem. Now, what is the use of LSA5? So LSA5 will be generated by ASBR router. ASBR router will generate LSA5 to share the information of external domain in OSPF domain, right? So here you can see, this is my EIGRP domain. Here I have perform redistribution. So this router, ASBR router, will generate LSA5 to share the information of this network, right, in OSPF domain, right, to share the information of external network in OSPF domain. And when router will calculate path from LSA5, it will install in their routing table with symbol E1 or E2, by default with E2. Okay, let me show you on R1. So IP OSPF database, see guys, external LSA. Who is generating? Router 10. Router 10 is ASBR. Why? To share the information of this network. This network is present in EIGRP domain. Here you can see this loopback, right? From 1 to 1.125.1. Okay. So router 1. Okay. LSA5. Who will generate? ASBR router, to share the information of external prefix in OSPF domain. And LSA5 can cross area. Now, last type of LSA is LSA7, right? So guys, OSPF works on area concept. Why we come up with area concept? To reduce the size of database. If I will show you the database of router 9, so see the database on router 9. So IP OSPF database. See guys, size of database is large, but even I haven't configured this network. I haven't configured this network, right? Suppose there are 5000 prefix in this domain. There are 3000 prefix in this domain, right? And router 9 can't handle much prefix in their database, in their routing table. So I want to reduce the size of database. Suppose the hardware configuration of this router is not good, right? Due to large size of their database, this router is hanging, right? In that scenario, we need to configure area. So we have different types of area. In one video, we will discuss area as well. So we have one type of area that is known as NSS area, not so stubby area, right? If I will configure this area to NSS area, so in this area, LSA 4 and LSA 5 will be filtered. LSA 4 and LSA 5 will be filtered. So this router is generating, router 10 is generating what? LSA 5. But if I will configure this area as NSSA area, so LSA 5 is not allowed in NSSA area, then ASBR router will generate LSA 7. ASBR router will generate what? LSA 7. Will generate LSA 7 to share external prefixes in OSPF domain, right? So let me show you. On router 9, see, this is type 7 LSA, right? With the help of LSA 7, ABR is sharing external prefixes now, right? External prefixes now. So it will make you more clear when I will discuss types of area, right? Like NSSC area, stub area, totally stub area, totally NSSC area, right? In that time, this thing will be more clear to you, right? Till now, we had discussed LSA 1 to LSA 7 except LSA 6. So LSA 7 will be generated by ASBR router, right? And see, this router will generate LSA 7, and with the help of LSA 7, ASBR router will share this prefix in OSPF domain, right? So router 9 will receive this prefix, router 4 will also receive, router 5 will also receive, and router 1 will receive this prefix. So here we need to run one more command on ASBR. If you will run one more command on ASBR router, so ASBR will start acting as, sorry, ABR router, on ABR router. Once you will run this command, area 3 NSSA default information originate, right? Once you will run this command on ABR router, ABR will start acting as ASBR, and this router, ABR router, will also start generating LSA 7. Okay guys, so length of video is very long, right? So in this video I am not going to discuss anything else, right? We will discuss types of network in different video. When I will discuss types of area in OSPF, right, in that scenario I will explain LSA 7 again. So for now, keep in mind that LSA 7 will be generated by ASBR router to share external information in NSSA area, because in NSSA area LSA 5 are not allowed, right? In NSSA area LSA 5 are not allowed. So ASBR will generate LSA 7. Fine. So thank you. Thanks for watching. If you are watching now, then definitely you like this video. So don't forget to hit on like button. If you haven't subscribed my channel, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Bye bye. We will meet soon in next video. Till then.